Hey YouTube, we're back this week with another video. Today we're giving our gritty white cabin a makeover, and we're giving the cabin doors another chance at life.
We'll be showing you how we prepared and painted the cabin walls, and how we cleaned and treated the teak doors.
Alright, so we're going to paint the cabin today. All this stuff has to come out. I'm going to rip off all the carpet, and we're going to repaint all this old, nasty fiberglass. Might ask, well, why didn't you just leave the carpet in place? Well, the carpet held so much dirt, and I'm asthmatic, so any of that dust and stuff just is not good for me. So I ripped up all carpet that was everywhere, and that glue that sticks on here, it was a pain to get it off. Still has the fuzzies from the carpet, right? I found that this thing right here, this guy, got it at Harbor Freight. This heats up everything. It just cleans up the fiberglass. So I clean this is. Compared to this. Just finished sanding the entire cabin. All the walls, got all the glue off. I gotta wipe it down with acetone. This is one of the worst jobs that I've ever done on this boat. Just awful. And then we're gonna paint in here. We're gonna use the rustoleum topside because I have it, it's free. I'm gonna use that, and that's it. On this piece here, I'm gonna use the rustoleum also, but we're gonna do a non-skid, just because whatever I put in here, I don't want it to be moving around. Everything else, I think I'm just gonna keep the same. See how the glue came out here fine. I still gotta sand up there. To start off with the non-skid part, I brushed off all the extra sand. I know there's a couple spots missing. I'm not too worried about it. I could always add a little bit more later, but we're gonna start off with here, and then we'll finish with the rest. So here we go. That's just two coats. And I think that's good enough. A couple spots might be missing a little bit, but I mean, I'm not worried about this. This is not something I'm gonna be walking on. I just wanna store stuff on here. I mean, it came out really good. I use medium grip from FGCI. And yeah, man, it came out really good. I might do another tack coat after. I'm not sure, see how much paint I have left, but yeah, it looks really good. All right, let's go on with the rest. Seeing as we're gonna stay overnight, you know, I wanted it to be as clean as possible with as little dust as possible. I'm asthmatic. I have to be really careful. Even sitting in here without a mask on for now, it's gonna bother me a little bit, but overall, I'm really happy with how it came out. I mean, it came out better than I thought. Taking apart the cabin door. I'm gonna sand it down and recondition the wood. This looks like teak. Piano hinges are in great shape. So I'm gonna restore this guy. So to sand in between these fins, it's almost impossible. You would have to do it by hand, and I was until I figured out this thing. And it does a pretty good job. So look, check that out. Yes.
What
Okay, so we got the doors sanded down, and we're gonna use this teak cleaner. This is a step one. And we wash it down with water, and then we let it dry. And once we let it dry, we gotta use a teak oil, wipe that on there, wipe the excess, and then let that dry, and they'll be done. All right, so this is the second step. We're gonna apply a layer of the teak oil with a clean cloth and let it sit for 5 minutes, and then with the new clean cloth, we're gonna wipe it off. Have the cabin bulkheads that I took out. They're all rotted, but it gives me somewhat of a shape and a form that I can make a template out of. See how bad it is over here, but it's going to give us something to work with. So you still have the old steps, so I'm going to transfer onto the new one. I laid out the old bulkheads on this half inch scrap plywood piece that I had. I'm going to use these as templates. So you can see I'm still missing a little bit of this part here, so I got to kind of like make it up as I go and see what fits and cut and all that stuff. So this is what we're going to start with. These out and see how they fit. Got that first piece cut out. Let's try to fit it in there, see if it fits. So this test fit came out okay. I'm gonna have to put some weather stripping in the corners there just so it locks off me in a little hole. But overall, it's pretty good. The other side's gonna be a little bit more complicated, but let's see. Got the other one in. Ugh. I kind of screwed up and I cut a piece off that I shouldn't have, but I gotta figure out how I'm gonna hold that. And then I'm gonna have to notch this out here, fit all this stuff, and then make maybe a box with the starboard that I have there left over, and make a box to cover this up.
Okay.
The weather's tripping.